Would you like to record business expenses as easily as you learned how to record deposits? Well, in this episode of QuickBooks Online Crash Course, you will learn how to record expenses and checks that you pay to vendors. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Vendors are people that you pay for the services the company needs to operate. The government requires that you report the totals of each category of expense. If you pay them with a check, you will use the checks window. If you are paying online from your bank account, you will use the expense window. And those are the only things you have to remember. For example, let's imagine on January 5th of 2022, we paid UPS for a business delivery $500 with check number 1001. Well, since this is a check, we must use the checks window. That's pretty clear. But what will be the result? Here we have the numbers in the trial balance that were the result from the prior video when we learned about deposits and income. So if we actually pay $500, that means that we have $500 less in cash, and cash in bank will decrease to $6,500. But because we paid for a delivery, delivery expense will show up on the trial balance for the first time as $500. Let's take a look at how to record it. In the top left, we click New. Then we go over to the column of Vendors and click Check. Now, we put in our own check number and the vendor whom we're paying is, I think it was UPS, yes, UPS. So UPS and the day we were paying the check was, or will be, January 5th. Of 2022. Now, the reason we are paying the check is delivery expense. So we click directly under the word category to get the pull down, then click the arrow and scroll up or down, whatever you have to do, to find delivery expense. Boom. And the amount of the delivery expense, $500. At the moment we click Save and Close, we can then click Reports, Custom Reports, Trial Balance, and you can see delivery expense showed up for the first time as $500, and cash in Chase Bank went down to $6,500. Exactly as we predicted. Let's do a second example. Let's imagine on January 6th of 2022, we paid Ned's Taxi $100 for rides that were necessary for business. We paid with the Chase Bank's debit card and they gave us this transaction number. Because the money came directly from the bank account without writing a check, we must use the expense window. But let's think about what the results will be after that transaction. Well, if we pay $100 from the bank account, then we have $100 less cash and cash in bank goes down to $6,400. However, at the moment we lose $100 in the bank, transportation expense shows up on the trial balance for the first time as $100. Let's take a look at how to record it. From the plus sign, we click New and go over to the column of vendors and we click expense. Now, this is paying to Ned's Taxi for a transaction on January 6th of 2022. And the reason we're paying Ned's Taxi is because of transportation expense. And the amount we're paying is $100. That's all you have to put. If you'd like to put the transaction number, I believe it was, whatever, you can put a description if you like. You can clarify the payment method by adding your own, but that's for another time. Right now, when we save this recorded expense that came from this bank account on this day, click Save and Close, and now you can see the results in the trial balance are exactly as what we expected. Cash went down to $6,400, and transportation expense showed up for the first time as $100. These are exactly the numbers we predicted. But now, let's take a look at the other reports. You know that these transactions were with vendors. So you can click Reports, and in the Custom section of Reports, you can click Transaction List by Vendor. And now you can see each transaction sorted by vendor. Right now we only have one for each vendor, but they will all be in a list with each one of them showing up here. And as we learned in the prior video, you can double click, go back to the window that you recorded the transaction, change anything you want, and if you save the change, the numbers in the reports will change immediately. You should also click Reports, Profit and Loss. Now, notice this is the first time that we are looking at our profit and loss with expenses in the expense section. Notice it gives us the total of the expenses in the expense section the same way that it gave us the total of our income in the income section. And then, of course, the difference is our net income, our profit, at the bottom of the profit and loss. Don't forget, the profit and loss is also a summary report. We could double-click any one of these summarized numbers and go back to the original transaction. And then after we see the list of every transaction in that expense, we can double-click and we can fix. Let's do the next one. Example 3, January 7th, paid FedEx $1,000 for a business delivery or a delivery that's related to business, and this time we paid it to FedEx with a wire transfer from our bank account, and here's the number. Obviously, we must use the expense window because this is not a check. So, before I do that, I like to click Reports, Trial Balance, to see if the numbers are going to be what we predict. Right now, we have $6,400 in the bank, but if we pay $1,000, it becomes $5,400. And of course, if we pay $1,000 more for delivery, then delivery expense will increase from $500 to $1,500. And these will be the results in the trial balance after we record this transaction. So we click New, Expense, January 7, the vendor whom we pay is FedEx, and the number for the transaction, whatever, the category, click directly under the word category to bring the arrow, click on the pull down arrow, and this is delivery expense. Click in the amount field and type 1,000. Now, when we click save and close, you can see that the trial balance is exactly as we expected with cash at $5,400 and delivery expense $1,500, just like we predicted. And let's take a look at the effect on the other reports. Well, if we click Reports, Transaction List by Vendor, FedEx is now added to the list of transactions, and we can see every transaction for FedEx in date order. You can also click Reports, and you can click Profit and Loss, and you can see the total expenses has increased because delivery expense has increased. And you can double-click the delivery expense account to get each transaction that has been recorded in delivery expense, and you can see which vendor gave us the delivery on which date, and you can scroll to the right to see the money amount and so on. If you wish to change it, double-click anywhere on the line, and you will go back to the original window that you recorded the transaction. And just like you saw in the prior video, you can change anything you want, and then all the numbers on all the reports will change immediately.